What's up, everybody? Happy Sunday, Sunday fun day here. It's me, Justin, and I am I'm already having fun playing for you guys here. Digging the chat that's going by. I see a lot of familiar faces. And also, make sure you join the chat if you're watching live. And you know, it's fun. You get to interact. You get to put out song requests, all kinds of good stuff. So always like to do this at the beginning of the live stream too. You guys out there, please tell me where you're tuning in from. I always love to see where you guys are tuning in from all over the world. And man, it's the holiday season. Hope everyone's having a great time. Hope everyone's getting their shopping done, all that good stuff. Speaking of which, if you have not done all your Christmas shopping, this is like my my music, you know, for my album pitch here. Are you lost in the woods without any Christmas presents for your music-loving friends and family? Well, fear not, because Justin Johnson just released a new album, The Biscuit House. Yeah, that's right. And that last song, Goes to the Mountain, is on The Biscuit House. And you can click on that link right here on your screen that says The Biscuit House, and it will take you to my store page, because there's very few left, but there are a few left pre-release bundles of my new album, The Biscuit House. It comes with an autographed CD, a digital download so you can listen to it immediately. It comes with a limited edition coaster, cocktail napkins, keychain, bottle opener, all kinds of cool stuff. Just got that stuff for this release. So you guys go check that out. Click that link. Even while you're watching the live stream, go to the store now. If you want to grab it now, because it's, there's only a few left, you know, so, make sure you go check that out. Makes a good Christmas present. Just saying. Oh yeah. We got everyone from Quebec, Panama City, Florida. We got, all over the world here. I love it. Also, let me know, you guys, what's your favorite song from The Biscuit House? You guys that have already gotten The Biscuit House here. I'm curious to see what you guys have been enjoying listening to, because I'm going to be playing some of the songs from The Biscuit House. Even though I'm playing solo right now, and The Biscuit House album is all full band, I'm going to do a lot of those songs for you here, kind of stripped down, you know? All right, let me do another one for you guys then. While you're out here, got North Carolina. I lived in North Carolina for a long, long time. That's where I met my wife Nikki. We love North Carolina. Out in Paris. Oh man, that sounds nice. Denver, Russia, all over the place. Let's see. Oh, we got a tip. Appreciate that, Andrew. Just put a tip in there. Would love to hear Blackwood Lullaby. Do you ever play live shows these days? Well, right now, these are the live shows I'm playing, these live streams. I don't have anything booked, you know, as far as like a tour goes right now. So this is definitely the place to catch me live. Blackwood Lullaby. I don't, you know, it's funny. I haven't played that one in a long, long time. Oh, hey, appreciate that tip, AJC 70 there. I really appreciate that. Merry Christmas to you, too. Awesome. I'm having a great Christmas season here in Nashville, in the new home, in the new studio, enjoying it with Nikki here. Looks like Frank's down in Franklin, Tennessee. You're not too far from me right here. Just setting some of my levels right here, you know. I'm not gonna do Blackwood Lullaby. I'm gonna do a Blackwood Lullaby-esque improvisation for you. So let's see how this goes. little Blackwood Lullaby, like, interlude, if you will. But I'm gonna have to brush up on that tune. I haven't played that in a long time, but that was, I remember coming up with that on my back porch. Me and Nikki were hanging out back there, and it was like the chord changes, the melody just kind of fell under my fingers, and it was like, oh man. I thought it was a song that I had heard before, and that happens a lot when you're writing. You're like, oh, that melody, that sounds good, but I think that's already a song. And then you kind of like stress about it for a while and figure out, and then you realize, well, I guess I wrote that, you know. But that's one of those tunes that kind of fell under my fingers that way. Hey, Julie Loofborough, thank you so much for that tip. I really appreciate that. Happy holidays to you too. And man, I really appreciate that. You rock. Thank you very much. Oh, yeah. Am I happy with this court guitar? I saw that. Yeah, I love this court guitar. This guitar, they sent it to me for, you know, court will send me a guitar every now and again for me to check out and, like, you know, see if I like it, I guess, that kind of thing. And they sent me this one, and it was amazing. It's such an easy guitar to play. This is like the Gold Passion. That's the name of the model. But I love it. It's a really, really balanced guitar. Sounds great plugged in, and very easy to play. I think a couple of tips went by. Really appreciate it, you guys. J Blues USA. I like that name. I like that name. And let's see. Awesome. This is your first super on a live stream. The super's like the tip that he sent out there. So I appreciate that. Also, Christopher said you inspired me to finally pursue slide guitar. Your cover of Curtis Lowe. Greetings from Guam. Awesome. Well, hey, appreciate that, man. Thanks for the tip. And Jason, too, another tip coming in there. You guys are too much. I love it. Thank you guys so much. I said Merry Christmas, JJ, Nikki, and Mr. Mojo. That's my little puppy. Soul of a Man would be a good one to hear. You got it. I'm gonna dish that one right now out for you, Jason. Appreciate that tip. Soul of a Man is an old traditional song, old traditional gospel tune. And one of the early recordings was from Blind Willie Johnson. He's one of the best, like, early blues and gospel singers and guitar players. And so I'm doing this song. This is sort of based loosely on his on Blind Willie Johnson's arrangement. But this song is on the new Biscuit House album. And again, that's going to be full band. That's a full band album. I'm going to do it solo here for you. August Rain, another tip coming in. I love the live streams. Thank you, Justin. Thank you, August. I really appreciate that. That's awesome. Glad you're digging them. So to do this song, I've been standard tuning right now, I think. I've got to put this in like an open E minor tuning. A lot of the tunes on the Biscuit House album are in open tunings, and this one's no exception here. I'm going to go open E minor. And let's see, did I play this? No, I didn't use this guitar on the album. I used this guitar, actually, this PRS right here, I think more than any other guitar on the album. And it was kind of, when I went into the studio, this guitar was sort of like my backup guitar in case anything happened. I had a few more like vintage guitars, you know, and this guitar ended up sounding better than most of the guitars I had when I'd go down and kind of like dial things in the studios. I was really surprised. And it's become one of my most used guitars. It's kind of like always by my side now, this PRS. And I think the model is a SC. It's a standard 24. And it's an all mahogany guitar. And man, it's surprisingly good. Really good guitar though. I love this thing. I'm just tuning it up in that E minor tuning like I was telling you about here. There we go. All right, I'm gonna do a little Soul of a Man by request out there. Hey, Valerie, thanks for that tip. Also, Malika, thank you. Appreciate it. You guys rock. Thank you so much. Worstest guitar player ever. Thank you for that tip. Appreciate that. Thank you. right, that was a little Soul of a Man by request. And again, that is the only that's the only cover off of the Biscuit House album, my new album that I just released. And again, if you guys are just tuning in, there are still some pre-release bundles left of the Biscuit House, and that bundle includes the digital download, an autographed CD, a bunch of cool stickers, like a cool Biscuit House sticker bundle, cocktail napkins, coasters, all of the like Biscuit House stuff. That way you can have your little biscuit on your napkin, you can have your drink on the coaster, kind of like enjoying the album, you know what I mean? So you can create your own little ritual with all the collectible swag that you can get with that pre-release. But if you want that, you can click on it. There's a little like the product button here on the video. It'll take you straight to the store. I think it'll open in a new window. You don't even have to leave the live stream, but you can go grab one of those right now if you want. You know, this is feeling good. I'm liking this tone. I'm gonna do another tune from the Biscuit House album, and I'm gonna retune for it. I'm gonna pop it in drop D tuning, but I'm gonna see who can guess the tune first, okay? And I'm gonna be popping it in drop D tune. No, it's gonna be G6 tuning. If that's any hint to anybody, what song it is. I don't know if that's gonna help any of you guys, but. Let's see if you can guess what song this is going to be. Hey, Ian, thanks for that tip, brother. Appreciate it, man. Ian McDonald. Play anything from the new album or grinning in your face. Happy Christmas, JJ and Nikki. You're awesome. You're awesome, Ian. Thank you so much. Say hi to my lad who just started guitar. Ian, is that Junior? Ian Junior? Well, either way, hello, and thanks, Ian. Appreciate it. Let's see. Jay Blues, appreciate that tip, too. And talking about Otis Redding and the Stones, what is it? How Strong My Love Is. I love that tune. I love that old soul music. And, man, you know when the Stones would cover those old soul songs, just like the old country songs, anything, those old blues songs? They just sounded so good, man. The Stones are such a good band. They're definitely one of my favorites. Hey, Lady K Does Art. Thanks for that tip. Appreciate it. Like that sticker right there with the, is that a cat or a fox or a dog? Let's see, this is gonna be, okay. All right, so I'm gonna do a tune from the Biscuit House album. I'm gonna see who can guess it first, okay? Looks like Sava got it. It's Before You Go. Good job, Sava. It's like Steve Price, a little late to the party there, but you got it right. Thank you. Rabbit, D. Martin out there. Thanks for that tip, brother. Appreciate that, man. Good to see you out there. Thanks for that tip right there. Appreciate it. And, oh, you haven't heard me play some Ray Charles. I'm going to play some Ray Charles for you next. So I got that for you. Thanks. Thank you. All right, that was Before You Go. That was one off of my new album, The Biscuit House. That's an original. Sergeant Amy, thanks for that tip right there. Happy Yuletide, Justin and Nikki and Mr. Mojo. I love it. Nikki and Mr. Mojo are getting a lot of love this live stream, and they deserve it. They are always working hard. Well, Nikki's always working hard. I don't know about Mr. Mojo, but he's doing his thing. That's our little puppy. But he does have the mojo. I'll give him that. He's a magical little puppy. All right. So I got a request for a little Ray Charles there. And let's see. I haven't done this one in a while. I think I'm going to do, let me see here. First of all, I love Ray Charles. Ray Charles is so good. Such a big influence. He does, forget which album it was, but it's like an album of all of his slow blues songs. It's one of my favorite albums of all times. I got in like a double album called Jazz Plus Blues. It was a Ray Charles album. And I just wore it out. You know, when you get an album, I think I was in college, and it was just like the most emotional blues music, just the way he sings and the way he has that swing and just put so much inflection in everything. But you know, Ray Charles, I've tried to mimic a lot of his guitar. On the guitar, I like to mimic his vocals, and him and Etta James are two of my biggest influences when it comes to like soul singers who have this like style that you can really translate it onto guitar, you know. The way that they bend notes and the way that they have like vibrato in their phrases. But I haven't played this one in a long time. Let me kind of get my fingers around it. See, I gotta tighten my thumb pick. I'm calibrating my moves right now. I haven't played this one in a while, but I love this one. And hey guys, saw a couple of cheers out there. Cheers, everybody. Let me see those cheers. Let me see those cheers emojis here. Those Justin Johnson members out there. You guys got those cheers. You do like a colon, and then the word cheers in all caps, and then another colon. All that, and that'll pop a little picture of me up doing a cheers. So here's to all you members out there. Thanks for joining. All right, let's do this thing. Little Ray Charles. Thank you. Charles right there. I got a woman outro for you right there. See, I got a little Deep River Blues request out there I saw go by. Let me knock that out for you right here. You know, when I heard this song the first time, it was on a tape, like a cassette tape, and it was Doc and Merle Watson live in New York. That was the album. And Doc Watson did this intro on it. And this song was like my introduction to the Travis picking style. And I remember I was, at the time I had just met Nikki and I was living in coastal North Carolina. And we lived about 4 hours away. She lived in central North Carolina. And I was just, you know, fell madly in love with her. And so I'd be playing a gig down in North Carolina, like on the coast. And the gigs would usually go from like 10 o'clock at night until like 2 o'clock at night. And then I would drive about 4 hours to go see Nikki, you know, and get there at like 6 or 7 in the morning. And I'd be listening to this tape though on the way to kind of keep me awake, you know? And so it was this song, and Doc Watson would always talk about how there's two parts. It was a thumb part and a finger picking part. And that was my introduction to finger picking, with those long nights driving up to see Nikki after those gigs. I'll play it for you right here. And I also want to say thanks for that tip out there, William. Said, could you please play Can't Find My Way Home? Let me work on that. Let me see what I can dish out for you, Will. I appreciate that tip. All right, here's a little Deep River Blues. Thank you. right, a little deep river blues by request. It's not originally a Doc Watson song, but it's pretty much a Doc Watson song, I think. I think he nailed the arrangement of it, you know, that Travis Picken arrangement. Hey, AJC70FI, thank you for that tip. Appreciate that. Said, would love to see you play a gig with Jimmy Duck Holmes at the Blue Front Cafe. Well, yeah, I'll have to look. I'll have to keep that name in my head. Jimmy Duck Holmes at the Blue Front Cafe. Well, awesome. Well, I appreciate that tip. Thank you very much. Looks like Steve Price gifted 10 memberships. So what that means is that 10 of you, because of Steve Price, everyone give him a round of applause. Thanks, Steve. He just gifted 10 people 1 month as a music lover, like a membership. So I have a members section on my YouTube channel here. And anytime you want to find out about it, you just click the button that says join underneath one of my videos. But in my members section, there's two tiers. There's a music lover tier, and there's a guitar lessons with JJ tier. The music lovers lesson, or I mean the music lovers tier, you get cool stuff. Like you get, you know, access to the members only community section. You get like cool members only stuff, behind the scenes stuff. We give discounts every now and again. We'll throw out some coupon codes on the website for the store page for all the members. They get these exclusive emojis they get to use during live streams. But then there's another tier, guitar lessons with JJ, which means you get to go, you get like, I think it's like 60, 70 tab videos where I have my videos and all the tabs are on them that I put out constantly with new videos. Live streams, you know, every month there's multiple live streams for all levels with guitar lessons where we get to interact and I can you can ask me questions, that kind of thing. I just got done with a couple guitar lesson live streams earlier today, actually. So that was really cool. But check that out. Click the join button under there. But Steve Price, long story short, he just gifted 10 of you people with membership, so you guys get to join the party. So that's awesome. Also, JG, I saw that tip go by. Thank you very much, brother. Appreciate that. Well, yeah, thank you. Awesome. Making sure there wasn't a message with it, a little sticker with it. Nice. Awesome, you guys. Well, hey, I am having fun here. Just chilling out. Sunday fun day with my best friends, you guys. Having some fun, picking some guitar. I got a request for Can't Find My Way Home. I haven't played this. See, a lot of times I'll write an arrangement and then it'll be a while before I play it again. And I'm trying to, I love this song because it, hey Martha, thanks for that tip out there. Appreciate it. You rock. And what is that little sticker? Little number one. Little number one. Thank you. Thank you. All right. Let me pull out one of these resonators. I got a little Delta Blues, itch in the back of my head. Let's see what we got going here. So speaking of Christmas shopping, right? We're all Christmas shopping right now. We still have, we just got a new batch of these Justin Johnson Signature low-profile humbucker pickups. Just got a batch in. We had such a great response to them. We just released them, actually, earlier in the month. And they sold out very, very quickly. But we got a new batch in, so they're restocked on the store. So if you happen to be looking for these pickups and they were out of stock, they are back in stock now. So wanted to let you guys know about that. And all of the albums, all the music, digital downloads, everything like that is at justinjohnsonstore.com. Really easy to remember. Margie, thank you for the tip, first of all. Margie requested Baby Leave Your Light On. Let me see if I can do that on the resonator here. It's going to sound a little different because on the album, so Baby Leave Your Light On, I just posted the video of the new single from my new album, The Biscuit House. And Baby Leave Your Light On is an original on there. And it's got, you know, on the album, it's full band. It's got the talk box, which I really love. You know, the talk box was a device kind of made famous by Peter Frampton, but it was actually invented quite a while ago by a lap steel player. And the goal is to like say words with the guitar. And so what it is, and after this live stream, you can check out my video of Baby Leave Your Light On. Because what happens is the guitar signal gets sent into a speaker in a little pedal. And then there's like a literal like rubber hose that comes out of it. And you have to stick the rubber hose in your mouth. And that actually shoots the sound of the amp into your mouth. And then there's a microphone that picks it up. So you're actually hearing the sound of the guitar in someone's mouth, which is really kind of weird. And in a cool way. It's like, it sounds really cool though. And Joe Walsh, Touch the Sun, you mentioned Joe Walsh. Joe Walsh does it too on, Rocky Mountain Way, that song, ow, there's like this bullfrog kind of sound that you get from it. But so anyways, on my Biscuit House album, I played the talk box. It's the first time I ever played the talk box on an album, and I just love it. Thank you. Hey, Malika, thank you for that tip. Appreciate it. White Rabbit, yes. Thanks, brother. Orange Blossom Special. Maybe I'll try something like that for you here after this. Baby, Leave Your Light On, again, from my new album, The Biscuit House. So, and you know, this live stream really is kind of like a way to remind you guys that I just released The Biscuit House album, and there are still pre-release bundles that are available. Like whenever we release a new album, like Nikki and I will get together and think about like what can we do that'll make this cool and interesting? Like what kind of limited edition stuff can we include with this album and kind of get people into the release of it? And so we got all this cool like stickers, all this cool swag that we decided to put together and design, all with like this Biscuit House album theme. And you just get a whole bundle of it when you order it. So go check that out. Again, there's links here under the video for the Biscuit House album. Go check that out at the store. And yeah, while it's still there, because we only do like a limited amount of them, so there's still a few left, and we just kind of wanted to remind you guys to go hop on that while it's available. I see Joe McGraw just sent, thanks for the tip, man. Appreciate it. Can you please, let's see, hear your version of Curtis Lowe? Let's see. Let me see. I think I might be in a tuning I could possibly pull that off. Let's see. Let me see here. I love that tune. I'm a huge Skynyrd fan, and that tune's one of my favorite, you know, because it really leans on the slide guitar. That Blues, thanks for that tip. Great to hear from you guys out there. Happy holidays to you too. Check out Little Ellie's Blues on YouTube. That's an awesome channel. She does some crazy covers of my songs. It's really awesome. Go check that out. But thanks. Happy New Year's to you guys too. Thank you. All right, I'm gonna do a little, try to do a little Orange Blossom Special kind of thing here for old White Rabbit out there. He requested that a couple songs ago. One of the things with blues music that I think goes back with like blues history, but it also was like a big part of rock and roll, is this idea of like the train beat, you know, and that's what the Orange Blossom Special was, a train. So that's kind of what the thing's all about. And when you create that train beat, you know, you really got to get that chug going. And then you got to get that train whistle. Train rhythm for you, a little Orange Blossom Special. Let's do it like that, a little Orange Blossom Special, something like that. I think, I'm not sure, was that song written, I know that song, like Johnny Cash had a version of that, that where he pulled out two harmonicas and he just kind of roll up and down one and then roll up and down the other. It was a really cool to watch Johnny Cash do that. Let's see. Oh, Joe Carter. Oh, wait. Joe Cutler. John Cutler. There we go. let me clean my vision here. John Cutler, thanks for that tip, brother. Appreciate it. For treats for Mr. Mojo. Oh, that is sweet. Mr. Mojo, he does get a lot of treats, though. But, you know, we will get more treats for him. And you are contributing to that. So that is very appreciated. Let's see, I'm gonna pop this baby in standard tuning now. Do a little, do another tune from the Biscuit House album. See, Ghost of the Mountain, Please. I did that one first. I opened the live stream with that. So when this is done, you can go back and listen to Ghost of the Mountain. Thank you for that request, though. Pop this baby in standard. You know, when I was recording my Smoke and Mirrors album, you know, we were down in the Mississippi Delta, and that was a double album. The second disc I recorded actually at the crossroads, like, you know, the story of the crossroads where Robert Johnson and similar, like, old, you know, Delta blues musicians would, the story was they would go to this intersection, this crossroads out in the country. And there's a specific one, and if you go out there and you play your guitar or your harmonica or whatever, then the devil would come out there and usually roll up in like a big shiny Cadillac or something like that. And he'd make a deal, or you know, you'd become like a famous blues musician. But the price would be your soul, you know. So. But I always loved the history with that and that kind of mythology and folklore behind it. But when I was recording my first album, though, me and Nikki were on the road. We were actually living on the road full time at the time, living in this old RV. We were thinking, like, where should we record, you know, my first solo album? And so we did it at Sun Studio, where, you know, Elvis, Johnny Cash all recorded their first albums. And then on the second disc of that album, took it down to the crossroads and actually tried to record at the crossroads on New Year's Eve at midnight. And hey, Mai, thanks for that tip out there. Can you do your version of Zeppelin's Bronjarstomp? I never knew how to pronounce that, Bronjarstomp. I don't know that tune, but I'll do a little Zeppelin for you a little later on. Thank you for that request, though. That's a great song, but yeah, I'll do a little Zeppelin for you. But anyways, long story short, ended up playing at the crossroads out there. And we pulled out, we went out to the crossroads and we were at a Dockery plantation. It was the plantation, the old like cotton plantation where Muddy Waters, he worked there, Son House worked there. It's where Delta blues like was invented, you know? And so it was out there, and while we were there, though, you know, you heard these stories about these old juke joints, like these old places, like, you know, the juke joints back in the Mississippi Delta, they weren't like, you know, they weren't like necessarily like official establishments where they had like licenses to serve alcohol and stuff like that. But back then, you know, you'd have this old barn maybe, or this old, you know, this old restaurant or something, but it'd become a juke joint. You know, you'd have this party, you'd be selling moonshine out of the back, you know. But you'd have all these like legendary blues musicians that would play at these juke joints back in the Mississippi Delta back in the day. So we heard the story of this one, this old juke joint that was called the Biscuit House. And it was like a biscuit house, it was like a restaurant during the day, but a juke joint during the night. They called it like Beelzebub's Biscuit House. It had like kind of a, you know, that's where the name of this tune, Beelzebub's Biscuit House, came from. It's kind of had like a, you know, a scandalous reputation, like those old juke joints did. But so this is Beelzebub's Biscuit House. This is the first song off of the Biscuit House album. Let me dial in a little bit meaner tone here, just to. Like not Delta blues, but a lot of that old like hill country blues, you know, it's kind of like this style right here. A little bit different than Delta blues. You get this bass line going like this, and it's just like a primal sort of thing. It's like a, you know, dancing around a fire. You get this rhythm going, and then you just you build off of that, and you kind of keep this pulse going. It's very type of like it's like a tribal blues style. But it's in that style. This one's called Beelzebub's Biscuit House. You got. Thank you. Bub's Biscuit House right there, and that is off of my newest album, The Biscuit House. All right, speaking of that old blues, I'm gonna play a little catfish blues for you guys. And I gotta pull out this other PRS right here. I got a little PRS collection over here that I just was in a PRS-y mood today. So I've got this baby out here. This is like the NF53 PRS. It's got a very like more of that twangy kind of T style vibe. Put this baby in some standard tuning. I'm gonna do a little catfish blues for you guys. When I say catfish blues, it's a style of blues that is kind of like based on a song. I think it was originally a Muddy Waters song called Catfish Blues. But I heard it first with Hendrix's version. And, you know, it's sort of become almost a style of blues, like a type of blues. Not just one song, but there's like a vibe and a riff that goes with it. This kind of thing that goes that little riff right there. Thank you. you very much for that tip right there. Tipped my chair back there. That's what happens when you pull out the catfish blues. You lose your balance, you know? Happens every time. Oh yeah, bottom feeders. I like that kind of analogy there, you know? Is the catfish or bottom feeders? That's undeniable. I love it. All right, I'm gonna pull the acoustic back out here. Let me get this tuned up. Let me go a little standard tuning here. Up my thumb pick right here just a little bit. All right, there we go. We got a little windy and warm request. I'm gonna knock a little windy and warm out for you here. Doesn't happen every day. I just got hit by a tornado a few days ago, which really was pretty freaky. When Nikki and I lived on the road in the RV, we had several close encounters with tornadoes. But I was here in Nashville. I live here in Nashville, and a tornado came through the other night, and actually. Everyone in the neighborhood's fine here where I live, but it came right through, tore a lot of houses down, there's a boat dock in my backyard. It threw the entire, is four boats, about 200 feet, and tornado was right in the backyard and made a turn and avoided my house, luckily. Everyone in this neighborhood's fine, but it was pretty intense. It was pretty crazy. So I just thought about that with this song, Windy and Warm. You know, it just reminded me of that. But again, really, really grateful. Really grateful to be getting through that okay. Appreciate it. right there. And Lapco92, thank you for that tip right there. You were saying you were, you had another close call with a different tornado, I see, back in 99. Well, you don't forget the sound. You know, we're lucky to have a storm shelter here where we live, Nikki and I, and me and Nikki and Mojo, we're in that storm shelter, and was looking, you know, we couldn't really hear much outside, and I went out to check after a little while, and I thought, you know, everything blew over, and I went outside, and it was in the basement. I looked out, and the doors to the basement were shaking, and my ears started popping, and basically ran back into the storm shelter, and that's when the tornado came through. It was really, really wild, really terrifying. Yeah. You know what was worse though, I guess, when Nikki and I were living on the road again, we lived in a 24 foot little repo RV that we got when we decided to hit the road together, Nikki and I. And when we were traveling around, we did a lot of shows out in like the Midwest, in that area, in Kansas, Nebraska, and you know, that's Tornado Alley out there. And it is so scary going through those storms in an RV. That was the thing. Like, luckily we were here in a home in a storm shelter, but so many times we had close calls out there in the RV, and there's just really nowhere to go and shelter. But man, you know, it's those adventures that that make up life, you know. Krager, thanks for that tip. Appreciate it. Oh man, I love that. Love that song. That's a little House of the Rising Sun. I'm going to shoot that one out to Ian McDonald out there if you're still listening. Love you, brother. And I wanted to thank Leon and Time for those tips right there that came in right at the end of that song. Really appreciate it. Thanks a lot, you guys. And Time, you requested a little While My Guitar Gently Weeps. Yeah, man, I'll definitely do that. Let me get this B section.
There it is.
Thanks, guys. Appreciate it. That was a little "While My Guitar Gently Weeps," Beatles. And I'll pull that resonator out right there. Thursday. I like that. Thanks for that tip. Appreciate it. Gary Clapson. Thanks for that tip. Awesome. Appreciate it. Questions go by on the chat about the guitar I'm playing and the tuning and stuff. This is a resonator guitar. You know, if you're not familiar with this type of guitar, it's actually made out of metal, and it has a resonator cone, which is kind of like a metal speaker cone, and that's this area right here. And so it was designed, early on to project the sound like louder than a normal guitar. But what it ended up doing, it is louder than usually a normal resonator guitar, but it actually just has this metallic kind of overtone, this really cool tonal quality to it. And then this tuning I'm using is, it's an open tuning, so it's an E minor tuning. It's a E, B, E, G, B, E. And so it puts the guitar in basically this minor chord, even without me pressing any strings down. So it's a little bit about the sound, the way I'm getting the sound that I'm getting right now. Robert, thanks for that tip right there. He said, hey, from the great white north, love what you do. Well, hey, thank you. Appreciate it. That's funny. Joe said Justin's music would have been great for the movie Dead Man with Johnny Depp. I love that soundtrack. That Neil Young, like you mentioned, Neil Young, that movie Dead Man, if you've never seen it out there, it's got Johnny Depp in it. It's a black and white. It's a Jim Jarmusch movie. And it's like a Western movie in black and white. But the whole soundtrack is just Neil Young just playing guitar. It sounds so cool. And that's one of my favorite soundtracks. But that's great that you mentioned it, because it's such a good, you know, it really sets the tone for the movie. And that was one of those like movies early on that really made me pay attention to soundtracks. And I think it was because it was so guitar heavy and guitar centric. It's just Neil Young. It's an acoustic guitar and an electric guitar with this really heavy echo. And it sounds really cool. Well, I got a Long Black Veil request. I don't know why. I've been playing that song every live stream now, and it's just, it always feels right. It's such a good one. Thanks for that tip. You're cracking me up over here. That's it. Appreciate it. Well, thank you guys so much for tuning in. Once again, please, if you love the music, go check out justinjohnsonstore.com. And while you still can, go check out those new pre-release bundles of my new album, The Biscuit House. I just released my new album December 1st this month, and I'm really proud of it. I'm really excited about getting it out there. We've been waiting for you know, kind of a while to put it out, really working on it for a long time. So make sure you check out the Biscuit House album, click those links, go check out the store. But most of all, you guys have a very safe weekend, a great holiday season. I'm going to be doing another live stream before Christmas. I'm going to be brushing up on some of my Christmas materials. So make sure you keep coming back to my page, hit that subscribe button while you're here. Click that little bell notification button so you get notified when I'm putting out new music. Ian Jarvis, thank you for that tip. I really appreciate that. Thank you so much. And man, it's always so fun hanging out with you guys. You know, this is where I'm playing live right now on these live streams. And it's so cool to just be here, hang out with you guys, have a fun time at home, and join the chat here, get to know you guys. Anyways, love you guys. Have a great night. You guys rock. Appreciate it.